We are sick and tired of being sick and tired.
It's a bargain, a steal, simply a good deal. But your flippancy devalues my existence, and you basically just told me to get over it. To you it's cheap and cheerful, to me it could be free, and I still would never bring it into my home. To me it's a reminder of the strangers that hate me, of the white men who've dated me, thinking that I give their racism some kind of impunity. To me it's a reminder of struggle, confusion and pain, of being asked the same questions again and again and again. To me it's a reminder of dodging jokes in workplaces and playgrounds, of staring contests in the mirror, of feeling alien in my homeland.
Just try not to think about it.
I try not to, I really do. I try and I try for all of you, and I'm sick of it.
It's a shame.
Yes it is, and it's the life that I live.
But they're all racist.
So you know, so why is it here in my home? And yet it's me that's making you feel uncomfortable. And yet it's me that's making you feel uncomfortable. Just value for money. I guess you've got other things to do than to consider how racism could possibly concern you. Except now, suddenly, 2 years later, you wanna tell your fans how much you care, and you must have really meant it, cause you had a hashtag and a black square. It'd been a really long day and I just had to say something. Hey, remember that time with the rug? I'd been reminded again and thought maybe now you'd wanna talk, but you just deleted it. Do you know what that's called? That's called erasure, and it's kind of just part of our social furniture. But now I know what it is and how to call it out. You could have used your blue tick, stretched your ego's range, had a real conversation, enacted meaningful change. But instead, again,